What's up, guys? Welcome back to the 23rd. Oh my god, that was some lag there. But anyways, welcome to the 23rd episode of the Terraria Expert Mode Let's Play series. We will first start off here with the Hall of Commenters. The 12th person, I think, into the Hall of Commenters is Pope now. Like always, if you do want to be entered, I guess, into the Hall of Commenters, make sure you just comment anything. It doesn't matter what it's about, whether it's about the episode or just something random. You will have your chance to go in there. So, in the last episode, you do recall that we did actually defeat the Solar Pillar, and I kind of talked about how I completely, like, forgot, honestly, about a lot of the bosses, like the Frost Moon, Pumpkin Moon, the Old One's Army, stuff like that. And so that's what we're going to be doing. And I know also I said that every episode from then on, we were going to be defeating a pillar. But I'm actually not going to defeat any pillars in this episode. And the main focus of this episode is going to be building our ultimate arena, which will span from that little thing there. And it's going to be completely flat. So it's going to go all the way from over there. All the way. Yes, it seems like a long way, because it is. And that's going to go all the way over to... Come on, where is it? Over to that, and you might be thinking, isn't that a little, you know, a little overkill? I mean, like, that entire area right there is going to be flat. Yes, you know, it probably is a little, overkill, but it just makes sure, that I don't have to worry, honestly, you know, about, having mobs spawn in other places, and, when the arena's done, you'll see kind of more of what I'm talking about. But what we did get in the last episode, which was, I would say, a bit crazy, is we actually got the Hollowed Key. And I said I would be opening that in this episode, and that is actually going to be happening. So let me go ahead and favorite that, and I will meet you guys back when we're over at the dungeon. Oh my gosh, guys, I am so dumb. I just realized, you know, we're over at the dungeon. And, you know, that made me think, well, we have the Hard Mode Dungeon enemies now. You know, which means, well, if you know what that means, there's some pretty nasty things you know, are gonna spawn down here now. And I realize we've completely forgot about that, too. So I think, actually, once we open this chest, we're gonna stay down here for a while. And, you know, just kind of farm out some of the, dungeon, you know, post-Plantera items. So, and I'll probably do a time-lapse of that. But, you know, I need to get some ectoplasm, all that type of stuff. And so if I go on the map here, I mean, is that the chest? No, that's the frozen chest. We have the hollow chest. Okay. So we have found it. I think we found all the other ones, actually. And so the crimson chest was around there, I think. So anyways, let's go down this... Oh, and there's a dart trap. Luckily, that doesn't hurt, though, now that we have some pretty decent armor. And the hollow chest should be right here. Sweet. So, let's go ahead, and ladies and gentlemen, we have the hollow chest in 3, 2, 1, after we kill this guy. Oh, I have, oh my gosh, hold on, we're getting attacked here. We already do have a bunch of ectoplasm. Well, not a bunch, but, you know, already got... What? We've already gotten a Kraken and a bunch of ectoplasm, so hopefully we, you know, we're getting some good luck here. And then we do have the rainbow gun, just some other, you know, kind of random loot. And then we will go ahead and remove these torches, just so that, you know, I don't get confused later when I'm looking for the other chests. Without further ado, I will go ahead and make kind of a little time-lapse here, basically, of us just going around the dungeon. I don't exactly know how long we're going to be going around. Hopefully we'll kill some paladins. I think they're called paladins, right? Yeah. And hopefully we kill some of those, obviously, because they do drop, you know, a melee weapon that is probably not going to be used, but maybe. So anyways, I'll just cut into the time-lapse now. Thank you. At this point, our inventory is pretty much full, so let's go kind of go over here what we got. We got a superior sniper rifle. We got a bunch of actual. Oh boy, we have a Diabolist here. Let me go ahead and take care of that. Anyways, we got a bunch of rifle scopes to go with the sniper rifle. We got the Kraken early on, the rocket launcher, a few Spectre staffs, magnet spheres. Got a bunch of banners and stuff. There are so many dungeon spirits. We already have 72 ectoplasm, and we got a platinum-ish coin. We got some adhesive bandages, armor polish, obviously the hollow chest, and yeah. Also, we got the wisp and the black belt and the tab eye. And I don't know if you exactly know what that means. Let me finish killing the this kind of last group here, basically. And then I will go ahead and magic mirror. Oh, right, we're, dang it. Okay, well, as we go back over to the house, I guess I'll kind of explain. So now that we have a tab eye and a black belt, and we now also have, now, we don't now have, but basically we've had the tiger climbing gear that we made very early on in the, series. We can actually make the master ninja gear already. Which is kind of cool. Obviously, we did get the rainbow gun as well from the hollowed chest, which I probably should favorite so I don't accidentally delete. And yeah, that's honestly it. Some of the things, obviously, we're not going to use because they're not melee orientated. Sorry. So yeah, hold on. Let's just go ahead and kind of quick stack everything here. And then we'll get our... Oh, wow. We actually have 3 tab eyes. So let me go get 1 black belt, and we'll take the others out, because we probably won't need them. We won't keep the adhesive bandage. Magic weapons. Go ahead and put our Spectre staff. Also, the rainbow gun, because, sadly, obviously, I'm not a, a caster or mage, but I am not going to be using that. Pets, I guess I'll put the wisp in there, because I don't really know where else to put it. Then we did get some banners. Darkcaster Bander, but I do see the Darkcaster Banner up there already. Come on, let us down. That we do have the Blue Armored Bones, where is it, the Dungeon Spirit, and the Rusty Armor. Those were the new ones. We actually have 2 more of those, so I guess we can go ahead and put that in the Banners chest, which is actually about to get full here. It is full, but we do have 3 more chests dedicated for banners. So let's go ahead and accessories. Oops, that's the wrong row. Get our... Oh, no, that's an obsidian rose. And that's the wrong row again. What am I doing? Get our tiger climbing gear. And now we can go ahead and make the master ninja gear, which is honestly pretty cool. And now that we have that, we can actually go ahead and sell all the other stuff. But we will put 1 rifle scope in there. And then let's go to guns. No, that's the wrong guns chest. Guns, we put our sniper rifle, our rocket launcher in. We actually have a decent amount of guns, now that I look at it. Hollowed chest, we can go put over here by the crimson chest, just on the other side. Like so. I think that's, yeah, that's lined up with the crimson chest there. Then we will go ahead and go to the yo-yo's chest. Where is that? And when we actually start getting into, like, the part where the only thing we have left to do in the series is just get everything, which hopefully will not be for a while. When it gets to that kind of part in the series, we are actually going to kind of resort the chests again, because I know I kind of resorted the chests like when we first got into hard mode, just because, you know. But and yeah, spawn point is set here. Just need to make sure that's a thing. And then we have the next thing which we are going to do in this episode, which is actually just well, I don't know how well this is gonna go, but we are going to attempt the Old One's army, just maybe twice or so, you know, just to kind of see how we do. And we do have all of the stuff actually unlocked, so let's go ahead and get the Eternia Crystal Stand, which I think I might have already bought before, but whatever. And then we're gonna buy two crystals because that's probably all we're gonna use. So, let's get a good spot here. First, let me restock on potions because I don't have a ton left with me. And wow, we actually have a ton of greater healing potions here. So, restock. And then let's go out here. And I mean, we're honestly kind of ready. I don't really have to prepare a ton more stuff. Although I just realized this is actually probably, yeah, this isn't flat enough here. So let me think. Where's somewhere that would be flat enough? I have an idea, and that is in the Crimson Desert. Hopefully, this will be flat enough. I have a feeling it won't be, but we can attempt it. So, come on, hold on. Let's go ahead and cut these cactuses down here. Our Eternia Crystal Stand. And oh boy, the Old One's army is approaching, and I just realized we are so dumb. We didn't bring our little flame burst staff. Oh boy. Well, now we're kind of going, I would say, kind of bare here because we don't actually have any of the staffs to protect us. Oh boy, we're dumb. We are very dumb. So let's go ahead and put our spider staff down. We do have two UFOs going out here. And then this wave luckily isn't extremely hard, but the only bad part is we are actually going to have, well, it appears we are going to have the regular dungeon, or did I say dungeon? The regular desert. That's the word I was thinking of. The regular desert enemies coming at us, which is kind of disappointing. That is actually kind of cool because it's like perfect that way. And why is it? What? Oh right, I have the here, hold on. So I have something called Creative Shock right now, which basically means I don't have the power to build anything, which includes mining out blocks that I don't want. So that's that might be a problem. And these are kind of weird here because they are in some weird form. I don't even know what. Oh boy. Okay. Yeah. See, without our flame burst staffs and stuff. This is actually going to be kind of hard. And oh my god, we have the stupid dungeon spirits. Or did I just say dungeon again? The desert spirits, wow. The desert spirits are sitting there trying to kill us. Oh, and we do have some damage off, but you know, we're just trying to get to the waves basically where we get the defender medals. So oh my, we're getting overrun. Oh my gosh. And I just realized it might be a tiny bit loud. And oh boy, we have these little like suicide bombers getting to our tower, which is not good, and we're losing health. Oh dear God. Oh, this is going terrible. But I wouldn't say we're necessarily the the best suited for all this right now. We do have, you know, the solar eruption, which kind of makes up for our lack of armor and all the other stuff. But yeah, the flame burst staffs, they help a lot, so it's gonna suck not having them. So let's go ahead, and we do have our the wyvern things now, which are going to be annoying because they're gonna swoop down and just basically wreck us here. So hopefully we can actually use a daybreak to take care of them. Nope, it seems the daybreak does worse. So I guess we'll just go back to the normal enemy, or the normal enemies, the solar eruption. And we are about to die. That's not good. So let me go ahead and use the vampire knives quickly. Never mind. We have too many mobs to do that. Oh gosh. Yeah, we're about to go down. And the waves are basically failed at this point. So yeah, we got to wave 3 and almost wave 4, but we were getting pretty overwhelmed there. So that kind of sucks. And I don't actually think we got anything regarding the event. So I'm actually going to just go ahead and put this into miscellaneous, because as you saw there, even with the staff, I don't think we'd be best prepared for that at the exact moment right here. And I am just looking here to see if I did buy one of those earlier, and it did not appear so. So anyways, let's go ahead. I just realized we have those mushroom chests and the mushroom door in there, and I think I was meaning to actually put that over here on our mushroom, or on our truffle. So never mind, we already have the mushroom doors, but we will go ahead and put the mushroom chest down here just kind of for decoration. Let's go back home. Okay, I was actually kind of worried there that we had left the door open. So anyways, let's see, what else do we have to do in this episode? Let me go take a look in the trophy room to kind of see what bosses we need to farm out more. So, Eye of Cthulhu we need to farm out more. We have Queen Bee and King Slime. Oh, I remember last episode with that whole King Slime and the, oh, sorry, I have to stretch. But the King Slime and the Hollowed Key, that was honestly the coolest thing ever. And we're probably going to get attacked by Wyverns while we're up here, so let me go ahead and summon that. So anyways, I guess what we'll do now is we'll just go ahead and build the arena. So this is one of the most resource and time-consuming things that I think we will have to do during the entire series. Except there's one tiny problem about that. You know, we have to do it like 4 times. Yes, 4 times, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's not going to be fun. Now, we're not going to do all the 4 of those times in this episode, but we do have to do it once. And this once is actually going to be the hardest time to do it. Because of the fact that we don't exactly have a schematic for it. So we kind of have to build it by, you know, like, thought, basically. So, yeah. And then the other ones are kind of easier because we kind of already have, like, a blueprint for them. I am going to buy some Clintaminator solution here. Because the Crimson, I noticed, I don't know if you heard it when we went down, but I will show you here. So if we go down into our Hall of Commenters room, and we go right here, you can hear, at least, yeah, there it is. You can actually hear the Crimson music. I'm going to go ahead and do that, and hopefully that should have somewhat removed the Crimson, although you can still see there's some kind of shady things going on down here, it looks like. So, actually, let me go spray. Well, we'll save the rest for over here. But, anyways, I will go ahead and do this time-lapse. Sorry for all the time-lapses that might be in this episode, but it is necessary because I don't want to make you guys, you know, watch all of this. This is going to be very painful, though, to fill in all of that with dirt. Oh, man, this is going to take a long time, but hopefully I should see you on the other side, and if I feel like even the time-lapse is going to be too long, I will probably go ahead and just cut the rest out. So anyways, I will hopefully see you not insane on the other side. I'm almost finished here filling up the areas under where the arena is going to be. And yes, I know, it looks really ugly. And there's actually a pinky right there, which is kind of cool. But anyways, I know this looks ugly, but it is just going, you know, it would take hours to actually fill this in with all blocks. And make it, you know, kind of neat. And so what I also did, you can see here, is I did spray some Clintamination. Is that the right word? I don't know. I sprayed the Clintaminator basically all around here to kind of give the hollow, because I realize one other advantage with kind of doing this this little pattern here is that since it's not all solid, these are actually all going to eventually be some sort of grass block, whether it's hollowed or crimson grass. Which does give us a chance then, because of that, for biome keys and stuff, which you know from, when was that? I think that was the last episode, actually, that we got an accidental biome key, basically. But anyways, I am going to finish here this last row. And again, I know it does look ugly. And one other reason it just looks really ugly is because it has no back wall. But you know, I eventually I might go fix all of this and you know make it more pretty. But for now, I just want to get the arena done and make it so that the mobs are only going to spawn where I want them to. And I've been talking about this arena, and I haven't really. And also, again, I did fill in this area over here. But I've been talking about this arena to you guys, and I haven't really explained how it, you know, how it works. Also, I did get a blessed apple, which is cool. I hadn't actually gotten one of those yet. And I think this is the fastest mob in the game, or mob, the fastest mount in the game. I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure it is. Anyways, so this arena I've been talking about, basically. And I just realized I also do have to flatten this area out over here. But the premise of how this arena works is you have a giant area that has lava on the ground, and then you kind of have this little like spawn platform basically in about the middle area of this arena, and then you go about 30 blocks up so that mobs can spawn under you. And because of this, and you have all the lava and everything else filled in everywhere, it basically makes it so the only place mobs can spawn is on a little platform below you. And once you've controlled, you know, where the enemies are going, you can do a lot with them. I'm probably just gonna set up. Now, I will have minions and stuff down there, but the probably what's going to be doing most of the damage is actually going to be some temple traps. And eventually, I realize if I get ever, or if I ever do get more arenas and stuff, I will need to go raid some kind of worlds basically to get more temple traps, because while we do have a decent amount with us, we don't have a ton of temple traps. So yeah, I'll probably have to eventually go get some more. But for now, and I know I said I was gonna do a time lapse, but I didn't actually do a time lapse of that just because that part's boring. But I will be doing an actual time lapse for the building of the arena. And there's another video I had recalled seeing on YouTube basically explaining the mechanics of how you can control the area or the spawn area basically of where the pillar spawns. Because I have done this type of arena before, but the only problem was the pillar can vary. Obviously, it'll spawn in the same relative area, but it can vary in the exact location. So sometimes when I have all my summoning gear on, I would have to fly out in the midst of all these enemies that obviously did a ton of damage to me when I had only summoning armor on, to go and actually kill the pillar and get the drops. But I think there is a way you can actually control exactly where the pillar spawns. And if that's so, I definitely need to go watch that video. I'll probably go look up some info on that, and then once I have acquired some more information on the spawning of pillars and all that, you will be seeing. Obviously, you won't see it necessarily, me looking all this stuff up, but then you will be seeing the time lapse of us going ahead and build. Also, I'll put this in boss stuff, and then go up and get my crystal here and put that in boss stuff as well, because technically that's kind of a boss. But yeah, but anyways, hopefully you do enjoy the time lapse of this arena, and I'll probably cut back in when the lava needs inserting, because we do have to use a lot, and when I say a lot, I mean a lot of lava to actually fill up the arena. So anyways, I will see you on the other side of the time lapse. Thank you. So, I realized after I placed the stone bricks, I completely forgot about finding the middle, or the very middle of this arena. And I did go ahead and find it. And I did cut that last part out there, because I actually did have to write it down. So if it is correct, when we get to the end of this side, we should have mined up approximately 238 gray bricks. And if we do mine up 238, that means it is even on both sides for that middle area there. And that little middle area will be where all the mobs are spawning. And all the, kind of area we're walking on right now will hopefully be, lava. So, oh boy. 228. Meaning this side is 10 shorter than the other side. So, that would mean we would have to scoot this over about 5-ish blocks. So now, this is so we ended on 228. So then, hold on. Let me just go ahead and mine all of this up here. Because now I will keep this just in case we completely mess everything up. But I will now go ahead. So 238. On this side. So now this will be 229 on that side, and oh boy, I'm just gonna cut this part out. Alright, so after a few minutes of being annoyed, I did actually find the middle, which is 233 on each side. So I was right in just saying we could have moved it over 5, but I went ahead and made it hard for myself. So now I'm gonna go ahead and make this go up. Basically, so that we just cannot see this bottom platform, but just a little higher than that as well. So I would say about there. No, that's not tall enough. Basically, we just need to make it so that enemies can spawn, and it's technically like off screen, I guess. And I think that's actually good enough. So, and obviously they're not going to be just spawning on here right now because they can spawn all across here. And that's where this next part comes in, which is putting all the lava in. Now, this part I will do a time lapse for, but there's just one part that is going to be extremely annoying, and that's getting the buckets, because we're not ever probably going to use the buckets after this. Okay, so we're gonna have to actually go ahead and mine for lead. Yes, we are, in the process of doing solar stuff, and we are mining for lead. And that's because from previous experiences, basically, you'll probably already know this, but basically, if you get, let's say, all of this, and you want to fill this all up with lava, also that looks cool being all flat. But basically, if you don't have enough lava to complete, oh wow, hold on. Did you see that? The crimson is like spreading really fast. But anyways, what I was saying was, unless I bring in basically in one go enough lava to fill all of this up for at least a little thin layer, then it's just gonna go right away. So unless I bring enough buckets to basically fill it up enough one layer, then it's just not gonna do anything. So I have to go now. Mine a bunch of lead out, excuse me, which isn't gonna be fun, not at all, because we're kind of gonna destroy the areas around here just going through and mining lead out. And oh wow, the crimson's actually pretty close down here, but I guess I'm kind of glad I discovered that the crimson is slowly sneaking up even under my house actually. So anyways, I will go ahead and do a time lapse of us getting the lead, or at least, a decent amount of lead. And then once we have the buckets, I'll probably say something, and then we will go ahead and dump all of the lava in. Alright, so at this point, I think I probably have well enough, and I just realized I had to throw those water boots away, but you know what, I'm probably never gonna use them, and I think I already have some, so anyways, I think I probably mined well enough lead here, And I'm actually gonna convert all of it into bars. And I don't know if I'm gonna use all of it for buckets, because I do need lead for other things, obviously, because in a lot of recipes, I guess, lead is actually in it. I mean, like, let's just go to the guide here and put lead in the crafting, just to show you how much stuff requires lead. So, anyways, I'm gonna make a stack of buckets. That's the first thing we're gonna do. Let's go ahead. Oh my god. Well, at this point, we might as well just use all of it. ladies and gentlemen, we have some, we have an issue. That is that now we have barely any iron or lead to do really anything else, but now we have, you know, 99 buckets and 15 buckets of, you know, well, not anything yet, but soon to be lava, and we also got 25 gold coins on our journey. And as we fall to the lava level, basically here's our little path we took, just, you know, kind of exploring more of the map, I guess. We'll kind of look at that. Normally, I don't like to, like, you know, kind of tear up my worlds. For stuff like that, normally I would have went to... Ooh, and there's a truffle worm, and we do need to start catching those soon. But normally for something like that, I would have gone to another world, because I didn't like my world to be all torn up like that. But I've kind of got past that and decided that, you know what, we'll use the resources in our world. And when they're completely drained, and when I say completely, I mean completely drained, then we can go to another world to, you know, farm out stuff like that. But while we actually have resources, you know what, we might as well use them. So let's go ahead and get lava. Basically just shift-clicking, or not shift-clicking, you know, just auto-clicking the lava into the buckets like so. And we do have, luckily, have a lot of lava down there. So, and I just had a weird thought. Is it possible, or is it, you know, any sort of possible that you could ever run out of lava on a world? Like, what if you just took all of the lava out? Could you ever run out? I think the answer would be yes. I mean, obviously, I mean, look at all the lava. There is so much, and obviously there's tons of it throughout the entire world, and then there's the huge lakes in the underworld, and then also the lava you get from mining out hellstone. But I guess technically lava isn't a, you know, a resource that is infinite. And I just also realized we need to get one stone brick. Because, I don't, actually two, just so the walls on each side of the arena are even. But I don't know if you noticed, but like, you know, let's say water somehow, I don't know how it would, falls on this area here. When the lava's here, it could go right over this edge into the arena, which would be bad. So I guess, without further ado, let's just go ahead quickly here. We have to do it quickly, and I stress quickly. And somewhat evenly, you basically just have to go around the entire arena and do this just to hope that we actually have enough lava to go ahead fill up the entire arena. It looks like we do, and I will quickly place this block here, and then we will place the rest of the lava just right there. And I think that's going to be enough because we pretty much placed it evenly. And see, there's one enemy nearby, and that's probably, or at least hopefully, it's a flying enemy. And I don't actually know where it is, but if we were to fly up here, right, to our block, and we were to stand on it, yes. See, all of the enemies are just going to spawn there. So, at this point, it does appear that our arena works. See, no enemies nearby, so nothing is spawning anywhere. But then, when we fly up here to our block... Like so. Hopefully, at least something will spawn here. I need to go higher. Higher? I think this height is fine. Yeah, because see, things are spawning. It's just taking a while. But anyways, now that we have that done, luckily, you know, we'll just basically use these buckets now, I guess, for the other arena when we make that as well. Or other arenas, I should say, because we still have... How many? Three more to go, at least three more arenas to make. But yeah, I mean, at this point, what I have to do next, and I'll do a time lapse of this, is go ahead. First, we will get stone bricks. We will get some stone slab walls. We will get some glass platforms. Let's just fill this up, you know, why not? And then sort items. I do need to do some sorting in the chests and some more selling, probably soon. But yeah, that's a thing. And then let's see, what else am I gonna need? I'm gonna need torches, obviously. I'm gonna need, oh, that's what I'm definitely gonna need. Well, first, planked walls, maybe. I'm not sure. But where is it? Where is it? Furniture. Hopefully, I have some campfires in here, and if not, I can make some. And it does not appear I have campfires. We're gonna get a water candle, a heart lantern, and then we can make a campfire already. And you know, those are just for buffs. And then eventually we can farm out the waves and events basically so much to the point that we also I just realized we needed a certain item. But anyways, hopefully we can farm out the events and items so much that eventually at one point we're gonna have enough banners to put in every arena for every enemy. Which would be definitely a tough task, but I did it on the other world, which is cool. And so I'm gonna need a sickle here, and you're probably like, okay, why did you just buy a weapon that does 12 damage? That's because I'm using it as my main weapon. No, I'm actually using it to get some hay here. And I just got a bird banner, which is kinda cool, because I don't normally get those. Because obviously I don't see a ton of birds. So let's place that down. Because I know I need the biggest advantage I can get when I'm fighting birds. But I do need hay, and that's for a controversial reason, and that reason being for dummies. Now, if you don't know, basically there's this little glitch that's, at least last I checked, it still works. But basically, you place two target dummies down, you get a slime saddle, which I will actually go ahead and get out of the mounts chest and put into my piggy bank. So we'll do that now. But basically, you put the dummies in like a very tight location. Then you'll go ahead and get on the slimy saddle, bounce on top of the dummies. You go up and down really fast. It's really annoying, you know, kind of noise. But effectively, what happens is it creates an invincibility frame quickly. You know, just for a second when you actually bounce, but you're bouncing so fast that it pretty much makes you invincible. Well, it doesn't pretty much, it does make you invincible. To my knowledge at least, I don't think I've ever been even damaged remotely, on, you know, using, like, the dummies. And I know I said it's controversial, and that's because of the fact that, I guess it could be kind of looked at as cheating. But, honestly, there's a point in the game where you know, right, you know that you can take down all the pillars and stuff, but it's just so boring and grindy and way too time-consuming to actually farm out, you know, every single pillar every time. And so we can use this arena actually for a multitude of things. We can, during solar eclipses, the enemies will spawn right there. And with a, you know, a pretty good row of traps, basically, we can make it so that the solar eclipse enemies pretty much die instantly, I would say. And we might actually need to expand this platform. And I want to talk about something else here quickly. I keep always pointing at, like, the screen, thinking, you know, like, trying to show you. But I realized then, I don't have a face cam, and you can't see me. So I don't know why I ever point to my screen, because there's obviously no point. Ha 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 ha. I'm funny. Anyways, so we are going to, I'm actually going to do this on camera here. Kind of design this little box. And this is going to be the same design. I've actually written down the calculations, I guess. Not really the calculations, but I've kind of made schematics, basically, for all of this area. And I just realized we do need to make this box kind of off-centered. So we need to, this is annoying to build up constantly like this, but I basically need to make the edge of the box where I'm going to be using the slime, or the dummies, I basically need to make that in the middle so that the enemies don't go wandering off the platform. So about right here, we are going to be placing down the dummies, so then we're going to be right there, and the enemies are going to be about right there, so that's nice. And I also do need to get the calculation, I keep saying calculation, I need to get the measurements, basically, for, how tall up from the arena we actually need to make this. So let me go ahead and get my slime saddle here. And I'm sorry if this is gonna be ear rapey here for a moment as I kind of demonstrate. That is one too short, so I do need to make this one taller, like so. That's two. And so, ooh, that's my UFO. So slime, this. this is basically what it is. And if it's still working, which hopefully it is, I basically, that right there, I'm invincible when I'm in that little thing. Which, yes, again, is kind of cheaty. I understand that, but, you know, it's just, I can't sometimes just continually farm out. I don't know why I just switched that twice. But sometimes there's a point where I just do not have the time to actually manually farm out some events and stuff. And I guess I'll kind of talk about this here as well. Eventually, I say eventually, I do actually want to have an arena for every single events, basically. Or not events, but I want to have like a farm for every single item in the game. Because I've realized at this point, and I've talked about this before, that if we just, you know, kind of ended the series when we had everything, or not even had everything, but basically just kind of completed the game, then the series would probably end in a few episodes because, you know. So I'm basically just trying to make this series last as long as possible because... I'm gonna go ahead and say it out right now. This series has basically been the reason my channel has been so successful so far. Well, I don't know why I said so successful, but, you know, this it's had the success it has. Honestly, without this series, I would not be anywhere close to the subscribers I have. Speaking of subscribers, and I know I'm kind of going like a little talk thing here, but oh crap, we just used a magic mirror. But... speaking of subscribers, thank you to... I just made an Instagram for the YouTube page, and we already have almost 300 followers on there. So if you do want to check it out, it is in the it's in the channel art. Basically, there's a little Instagram logo. If you click on that, it will direct you to our Instagram page for the channel. I'm going to post, you know, some exclusive stuff. Maybe eventually do giveaways, you know, like exclusively on Instagram. No, I'm not too sure yet, you know, how I'm gonna do all that and all the exclusive stuff, but it's gonna be a good time over there. I'm gonna upload some pictures. I might even do like my first face reveal on Instagram. I'm not sure. But yeah, I think I've gained like 3 subscribers. I was talking to some people over on the Instagram who had found it, you know, about the channel and how they subscribed. So if any of you people had are watching right now and had been talking to me yesterday on Instagram and were the people who subscribed, thank you so much for the support. We are definitely a fun kind of community, and I'm trying to make it, you know, as much as entertaining as I can, even though sometimes I say and do some really stupid things. You know, luckily you guys bear with that. So anyways, eventually here is going to be teleporters that will go ahead and teleport us basically all around the world. And then we can go ahead and set up our campfire, and this is actually why I brought the glass platforms. But I think we can set up the campfire right here, because I don't think I'm going to be using this area. And then the heart lantern, and then the water candle, like so. So now we have campfire, heart lamp, and water candle for that nice, sweet life regen and stuff. And so if we're sitting here, hold on. Just waiting for it to say, you know, like an enemy is nearby. Okay, so yes, the enemies are confirmed. This is working. Only the enemies are spawning basically right here. This is great. Honestly, we've actually made a lot of progress this episode, and obviously it doesn't necessarily seem like it, but we have actually in terms of progress. And I almost just fell out of my chair there. I was like, I don't even know. Some again, if you're watching this, from Instagram and, you know, are new to the channel, you probably are like, what is this guy? You're like, he is stupid. And once you say that, you're correct. Sometimes I am very stupid. Anyways, let me go ahead. We're gonna get our spear traps and spiky ball traps, because I do actually need to go ahead and wire those up. And we're gonna go to the mechanic here by, I would say, a good 200 wire. Not that we're going to use 200 wire right now, but, you know, it'll be useful to keep. And then actuators I'm going to need a decent amount of, like so. Switches, I'll buy a few here. I'll just buy 10 or so. And then what we need to also do is go ahead and make a 1-second timer, which, if I'm not mistaken, is made with a stone block, a gold watch, and a piece of wire. So let's go ahead and get our gold out. We'll get chains. I think we can make it with just that, right? Gold watch. Gold watch. Oh, it's at a table. That's a crafting table. I'm dumb. Yeah, so here's a gold watch, and then if we go down to crafting, which should just be here, we should be able to make a 1 second timer unless I don't have an ingredient. So let me actually see. This is why the guide's nice. You know, when I don't know things, I can do that. So it's just, where is this? Anvil. Okay. I guess that was my mistake. I'm not sure. So let's go up to the anvil. Yes, there's the 1 second timer. So, and let me also put away our gold because that's just kind of cluttering our inventory at this point. So let's put that back. And I don't know why I thought there was stone in it, but I'll just throw that away. And I guess I'll cut out this next part here. Basically, I'm just going to fill in the back walls, kind of spruce this place up. And I'm also going to install some traps, you know, just for that nice added fun bonus. So I'll be back when that is done. Alright, I think that is good. So basically, I put some stone slab back walls. I have everything decorated-ish, and then I do have this little door here so that we can get in and out. And then I did set up a bunch of spear traps and spiky balls. And so yeah, I think now that that's done, there's one thing left to do with it, and that is go ahead and actually test it. So let's first deposit everything. And I just realized we can't really quick stack much, so let's put this back. Keep the slimy saddle obviously right there. Spear trap, let's go blocks and put all of this back. Because we won't be needing that hopefully for a while. Wiring, we'll put the traps back. Sickle, do I put that in swords? Why not? So yeah, there's basically one more thing left to do, and that's to test this arena. And I guess there were. What should we test it on? That's the real question. Because we don't actually have any pirate maps or anything. So I guess what we can do is kind of. Well, first, actually, I wanted to go look on the map here. That looks sick. So yeah, we do luckily have this done, and you can see the grass is actually growing along with the crimson. It's coming back pretty quickly here, so hopefully the hollowed, you know, kind of speeds up and takes over all of this. But I mean, look how fast the crimson spreads compared to the hollowed. Speaking of that, let's go do our like kind of daily check. It seems like status. 13% hollow and 30% crimson. One of the things I'm actually planning to do on the very end of my series is attempt to get 0% crimson rate. And there's these things called biome boxes, and I don't know if you've ever heard of them. But basically, what they do is they contain biomes, such as the crimson biome, into like a little 500 by 500 area. And sometimes it's way smaller than 500 by 500. But I've done biome boxes before, and I did 500 by 500, which you know, is probably overkill. But sometimes I like to do things overkill. So what we're actually gonna do while we kind of wait for it to be day is go down into the lizard temple and farm out some power cells, because we do need to farm out Golem a bit more. So I'm not gonna make a time lapse of that just because I don't want the episode to actually be too long. So I will be back, hopefully with a solar eclipse in our new spangle-dangled arena. So I'm coming back in here quickly to show you kind of a weird glitch I actually found. So I'm waiting for one of the lizards to fall down in here. Let me turn off my UFO. But basically, when they go into their little rage mode, they actually go. Oh, come on. Come on, you just did it for me. But basically, they go into their little, like, rage mode. And see, and now they're not doing it, of course, because I'm recording. But I think you saw one there, actually, when I was first coming back in. They basically just clipped through the ground and kind of just fell. So that was kind of funny. So, anyways, I'm going to continue farming out. Also, I did kill a. What's that called? Well, number one, I killed Plantera, but I killed a armored skeleton, I think is the name. And actually got a beam sword, which is cool. So yeah, I'm not gonna make a time lapse, but I thought I would just cut back in there because I saw that little glitch. All right, I'm gonna go back because it is actually getting close to night. And so let's first open this. We got a wasp gun, sweet. So if I still was using the early game stuff and how long we actually went ahead and used the what's that called? I'm trying to think of the name. Oh, the bee's knees and the bee gun. Man, though, if I had the wasp gun in early game, like before hard mode, man, I think I would have went through there in like a day. And like, yeah. So anyways, let's go ahead and put this back. We can go into swords, put that back. Flying snake banner. I actually managed to get one, and there is because there is one down in the temple that I obviously just use for the temple. And it is daytime, so let's go ahead and get a solar tablet here. And I just realized another time. Oh, I swear everything needs one of these little bewitching tables, but I am going to buy another bewitching table to go ahead and put over in the arena. So let's first get the solar tablet here and summon that. And we do have our slimy saddle we are going to use. And then we're going to attempt. Actually, that kind of looks cool right now. But we are going to attempt to do Golem here first before we get completely, overrun by all the other enemies. So let's attempt that. But hopefully he should just be pretty easy with our solar eruption. Yeah, this is kind of wrecking him right now. And I actually I realize, I think this is only the second time we've actually done a Golem battle on camera, not in a time lapse or something. And I do apologize if my voice is kind of being drowned out here by the solar eruption. So I'm just gonna do a time lapse here after this. Yeah, so I'm just gonna cut into the time lapse for the solar eclipse and the other golem. So the solar eclipse is over. Let's go ahead and turn the traps off here. And I hope at this point the episode's not too long. Obviously, I don't know at this point, but it feels like it might be a little long. And if you go look at the loot and just the overall stuff we got, I mean, we didn't really get much, and I'm gonna go ahead and open those up there. Yeah, we didn't really get, you know, kind of that, I don't even know what to call it. Like, you know, like the drops and stuff that I was expecting. So basically to end off this episode, I am going to first quick stack everything. Miscellaneous, we will put the broken hero swords. And then accessories, we will put these. And I know I need to sell a bunch of stuff again. So let's do guns, stinger, ammo, you know, blah, blah, blah. We did get a platinum-ish, though, and I think part of that was just the golem bags. And I don't know why I'm going up there. But I think just the arena is kind of off. Not in terms of centerness, but... centerness, is that a word? Anyways, but just in, like, the terms of traps and just the overall power of it. So I'm going to go ahead here and actually put some, I only have one flame trap. I guess for now, we're just gonna get, 8 super dart traps. Yeah, that's a bit overboard, I think. So basically we're going to expand the platform. And a Frost Hydra staff and some better minions would definitely, be better for this arena. But I mean, look how small this platform is. I saw like most of the enemies were just like running off of it. So and let me make sure I do have this even on both sides when I do go ahead and do this. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But yeah, I saw that the platform was probably way too small, and I'm actually gonna cut off one of the sides like that. And then the super dart traps, did I bring actuators? Yes, but I didn't bring wires. What a stupid idiot. I don't... I kind of like changed voices there. I don't even know what that was. So anyways, yeah, I'm going to kind of do the same thing I did with the... I can actually go ahead and replace that. But I'm going to do the same thing, kind of what I did up here, basically how I place them down and then I actuate them. So I'm going to place them in succession, such as this, and I'm actually going to scoot them back one more. And let's go ahead and do that. Then, come on, there we go. Alright, and then we will actuate them, and then obviously the actuation won't stay forever, just, you know, obviously so that it will do it that first time, and for some reason, I was worried that we were putting wiring over the golem altar. I don't know why, but, oops, we just took that off. So, we need to go ahead and place that. Oh, and we misplaced it again. Wow. Alright, man, we are, we're doing great here. So anyways, we will go ahead and put the wire all the way down. We will turn on the, 1 second timer just about once here. Make sure it cycles through once. And we'll go ahead and turn it off so that... Am I missing something here, or did it not work? Let me try this again. Okay, now it worked. Maybe, I don't know what just happened. So anyways, now I will get the actuators off. Hopefully not have them fall in the lava. And then, hopefully this will make the arena just a bit better. And so off camera, I might farm out, you know, just like a few solar eclipses, just to kind of finish up the drops on that. But anyways, I will go ahead and end the episode here. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this, you know, today's episode. Tomorrow, we won't also be defeating a pillar, at least I don't think we will. Probably, again, be doing some more things like the Frost Moon, stuff like that. So anyways, guys, hopefully you did enjoy today's episode. I said this already. Make sure you follow the new, you know, the False Demon Instagram. I do have that posted on the channel. If you go to the channel, like, banner, basically, it's kind of there with a little Instagram logo. Anyways, I'll stop rambling, and I will see you in the next video. Peace out.